Still on the crutches, man.
Yeah, man, what a long winter. Wow, dude, your hair looks like shit, man. Oh, you gotta get a haircut.
Yo, what's up, Dre? How you doing, man? What's going on? Good to see you, dude.
Right on, man.
Who's that?
That's my barber.
Yo, what's up, man? My name's Lyman.
What's up, man? Dre.
Dre, nice to meet you.
Pleasure.
Help my boy out. He's looking rough.
I've seen him. I think today's the day.
Let's do it, man.
Sure.
Let's go.
Let's get it. Come on in.
Welcome, Chop Live fans. We are here at Brand's Barber Parlor on Washington Street, East Stroudsburg, and I can't wait to see what Eric and I look like afterwards. I'm very excited. This place is awesome. Let's head over to the boys in the chair and see what it got in store for Eric.
Dre, my barber, aka my savior today. It has been, when's the last cut from you? Before Thanksgiving?
A long time.
A long time.
Too long.
Too long. Now, Dre, we're in East Stroudsburg.
Correct.
Talk to me about your other two spots.
Correct. We're at the bottom of the hill here in East Stroudsburg. Got a spot in Tannersville, 10 minutes away. Then we have another spot on top of the hill in Pocono Summit.
Beautiful.
And
this is your baby, though. This is your starter, right?
This is the
right?
original location. You could call this the headquarters.
The headquarters.
This is where it all started about just about 4.5 years ago now.
Okay.
You know?
What? Talk to me a little bit. Give me a little history. Talk to me about your passion into this game.
Well, you know, I've been cutting in the area for some time. You know, I started around 04, 05, right here in Stroudsburg, developed a good following, and been traveling a little bit. I went away overseas, cut in Japan, cut in Italy.
Did you hear that, folks? Not a lot of barbers that are cutting my hair in the Poconos. cut the jib or whatever. There's a saying there in Japan and Italy. That's pretty
sick.
Yeah,
it was a great opportunity.
And you, this is another thing that I found. You really love this industry.
Yeah, this is a passion for me for sure.
You're a student in this game. I mean, you
Absolutely.
Really are involved in it. Talk
Absolutely.
To me about the chair.
Well, you know, the aesthetics of it, the old school history of it. You know, these chairs, this is from the 30s.
Take a look.
Know, you know,
I mean, it's insane.
You can see how worn out it is. You can only imagine how many feet have touched that rest plate. You know, and that one behind you is pretty old.
Take a look at that, Karen.
1910.
Show it around. And a high from Ronishka over there too, and the puppy. do a spin, Van Alignment.
You know, that's a
nice.
That's an old chair right there. There's a lot of butts
in the seats.
A lot
seats.
Of history, a lot of secrets on in that chair.
So
know.
Let's get started, okay? What's the first thing? I'm sitting in your chair. You got the fresh this Beetlejuice on. I love it.
You know.
What's the first thing you're going to do? What are you looking at me? You're just
we're trying to figure out what you like, you know, what you're trying to look like.
It's got
to
be a mullet and a Fu Manchu.
I mean, we got it.
Stay tuned. Dre, what's your favorite haircut? Is there like a style or something that you really love?
My favorite. I would say the skin fade.
Ooh.
The skin fade's a classic haircut that just will always last. And it's just, it takes a lot of skill, you could say, to get that transition from the longer hair all the way down to bald to nothing, you know?
Nice.
So
it's not the mullet that you will be executing on me today.
Well, you know.
That's second.
Maybe we'll see
second.
A skin fade later.
Yeah, skin fade to a mullet to a skin fade. Cool, man. Thanks, man. Keep it up. Thank you. Love you. Thank you.
that is one gorgeous do.
Dre, thank you so much. The Poconos does not know what hit him. Interesting things on the wall. What's up with the haircut there on the top?
Okay, there's some travels going on here in these pictures. The top picture there, I'm giving someone a shape up on a balcony in Sicily.
Damn.
That's in Palermo, actually.
So that's you?
That's me giving
someone the cut.
Exactly.
And then the other stuff, like the pictures of, you know, the cars and stuff like that. Is that something you took?
Yeah, I took those pictures also. The next picture to the right of it is a picture off of a Paris balcony.
Wow.
Okay, that was in, I believe the neighborhood is Basile's.
Nice. Trey, what about that first picture?
Okay, the first piece there is one of the first pieces to my collection. I got that one at Art Basel in Miami around 2017. It's from a Colombian artist named DJ Lou. It's portraying a young Barranquillero, which is like a young child from an area called Barranquilla in Colombia. And he's playing an instrument. And he's pretty much showing what they do in the neighborhoods out there. They'll go play for people for money.
All right, Dre, my man, let's chat. Let's talk it out.
Let's talk about it.
So, Dre, we talked a little bit about your background. We talked about some of your pictures in your shop. Now, let's talk about how can I make an appointment. I want to know. I want to get cut by you, any one of you guys. What do I do?
Okay, so you just have to go to brandsbarber.com. Once you go on there, you'll be able to pretty much log into Booksy, which you would download onto your phone, and you can see the schedule right on the Booksy app. But feel free to call us. All you gotta do is give us a call. We set you up. No worries. We don't gotta complicate things. But if you're tech savvy, Booksy's a good way to go about it.
Booksy's the way to go about it. Perfect. Now I gotta know. You've been doing this game for a long time. Tell me about, did you ever screw up somebody's haircut?
Definitely.
Tell me about it.
Everybody has their war stories. I remember hooking somebody's mustache up a little too thin, and the guy went crazy. He was not happy, to say the least. It's safe to say he didn't pay for the haircut. You know what I mean?
He got the freebie.
You gotta give up a freebie if you're messing up the mustache.
That's the way to go. Is there anything that you want people to know about what is different about Brands?
Well, you know, Brands is a place where you can bring your family. It's a quality location, quality haircuts, barbers that have passion.
You are trying to give a full experience. Is that really important to you guys?
That is very important. It's trying to give back the old school experience of the shaves and just the overall feel, you know, in terms of the aesthetics and also just the relationship with the community and just making sure people feel good in the space, you know?
Yeah.
That is the biggest thing for us, is like everybody feels like family when they walk in. You're familiar, and if you're not, you become familiar.
This is gonna work. Look at him.
You know what I'm saying? This is what my man at Brands does. Dre, love you. Taking care of your boy. Oh my goodness, so fresh, so clean, clean. Dre, my man taking care of us today. I feel great. Lyman looks great. I mean, this is what it's all about. Thank you very much. The website is
brandsbarber.com.
Check it out.